بسم الله والحمد لله وصلى الله على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the beneficent, the merciful. And through that example in which he's given to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, greetings to all of humanity, those who seek peace and truth and justice everywhere. Stand for that in which is truth and refute that in which is falsehood, no matter what the cost, even if it's upon themselves. My beloved siblings in Islam, whom we share the commonality of the oath of allegiance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to his beloved messenger and all of those prophets before him and those who follow until the day that we all meet the one creator who created us. And to proceed, 25 years of historical information for Muslims in the Western Hemisphere to give a clearer picture and understanding how the watered-down version of Al-Islam, known as secular Islam or colonialist, imperialist Islamic, practitioners of colonialism whom have decided to stubbornly refute the Quran, the word of Allah, refuse to refute the clear proof and evidence in which authority was being questioned. Those whom have decided to do so are the same whom Allah is putting through this test and the trial in the Muslim world, in the Middle East, everywhere in the Middle East. Our Middle Eastern believers who come to America, let them come to share the rose of Al-Islam and only Al-Islam, not Arab nationalism, not to somehow prove that Islam belongs to Arabs, belongs to light skin complexion. The lighter the skin, the more Islam you have. There is no such thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created all of us equal, and in fact said that the worst of the people is the Arab Bedouin, because they reject the most and they also refute the most in a hypocritical way, and therefore do not follow the ways of those whom earn the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, earn the dissatisfaction of Allah, but follow the true guidance that he has given, the true light and the true salvation that he has given, one of divinity everlasting, one that is perfect, absolutely grateful to Allah no matter what the situation, no matter what the circumstances are, that in which is a win-win situation for the one who follows the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask again, stop selling and stop being involved in the transactions of alcohol, of lottery, of bigotry, of hypocrisy, of mockery. Stop belittling the Quran and stop belittling the people and the commandments that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon the practitioners of the Quran in order to give the peace and harmony and balance and justice to the entire humanity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if you all give us and free us here in America and give us our proper right, give the indigenous the true and the pure Islam here in America, this will be the grounds of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is only for peace. This is only for the everlasting peace that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised through the oath of allegiance of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The situation in Gaza, as we understand it, it is desperate, and the only long-term, everlasting jeopardy that will serve there is if everybody who understands the situation and are conscious of the places of worship, who can ever justify embarking on another place of worship with tear gas, with bullets, with violence on another's? Had it been your own, would you do that? And this is now what has to be addressed. First and foremost, we, the People's Republic of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, request that the Israeli authorities, they hold whoever was the highest commanding officer on the ground responsible, to show goodwill in that they are indeed in for peace. Secondly, all of the evictions which are considered international law violations, also we are demanding that to be taken as a deterrence of peace, and sweeping and putting those aside in order to increase the prospects of peace. Third, we also require that all hostilities be ceased immediately in order for the peace process, as well as the humanitarian efforts, be maximized and the refugees be attended to, as well as those whom have suffered on both sides of this particular conflict, including those who were merely just on the way. And we are praying that everybody do what is within their capacity to create a longevity.